You like children.
I do if they're properly cooked.
W.C. Fields detested children and always portrayed them as nasty little swine.
Don't you love me anymore?
Certainly I love you.
Don't you strike that child.
Well, he's not going to tell me I don't love him.
Of course, there were exceptions.
I'm very fond of children. Girl children, around 18, 20.
All fudge. Cease! Don't you use that sort of language before my innocent little daughter, or I shall be compelled to lay hands upon you.
He was against motherhood, fatherhood, and brotherhood, and took every opportunity of denouncing these popular virtues. The honeymoon. He talks to his Indian pal, Milton.
Milton, my brave, go upstairs and park your stoical presence outside the teepee of Mrs. Twilly.
We're married, you know.
I proceed to the local gin mill and absorb a beaker of fire water.
Big Chief got a new squaw?
No, is right. She hasn't been unwrapped yet.
He was against marriage.
Women are like elephants to me. I like to look at them, but I wouldn't want to own one.
He took great pleasure in throwing in morbid jokes involving relatives.
Mr. Whiffen tells me your wife has passed away.
Yes, the poor dear was killed in Upper Sandusky. Run over by a pie wagon.
Or there is this little touching scene.
Did your wife have any distinguishing marks? Any birthmarks?
Sir?
I'm sorry, but I have to ask.
Yes, I must confess. She had, sideburns.
Sometimes his attitude towards marriage softened.
Why didn't you ever marry?
I was in love with a beautiful blonde once, dear. She drove me to drink. That's the one thing I'm indebted to her for.
He wrote many scenes in which he himself was the victim. Here he is, pitted against one of his pet hates, waitresses.
And another thing, you're always squawking about something. If it isn't a steak, it's something else.
I didn't squawk about the steak, dear. I merely said I didn't see that old horse that used to be tethered outside here.
The waitress, of course, gets even when she takes his order.
Two fermented eggs in glass.
Cup.
Yes, cup. And some whole wheat...
White.
Some white bread, yes. And a cup of mocha java with cream.
Milk?
Milk, yes, that's fine.
Two in the water, easy.
I don't know why I ever come in here. Flies get the best of everything. Go away.
Another characteristic is his obvious lack of sympathy for human suffering.
I didn't sleep well last night.
You didn't, man?
I'm troubled with insomnia.
Oh, insomnia. Well, I know a good cure for it.
Yeah?
Get plenty of sleep.
To show his lack of sympathy, here Fields is telling one of his tall tales.
How are you?
Your son tells me you've had quite an experience with wild animals.
Sort of a big game hunter.
Well, I had quite an experience up at Lake Titicaca. Yes, up at Lake Titicaca, I had a wonderful experience with a rattlesnake.
Stop it. My wife's allergic to snakes.
Now that he knows that the woman has a morbid fear of snakes, he really pours it on.
As I was telling her, up at Lake Titicaca, I had a rattlesnake. I don't know.
Probably had too much to drink.
Out of Lake Titicaca, this rattlesnake was imprisoned under a rock. I took the rock, rolled it off the little fellow's back. To show his appreciation, he followed me down to the, followed me down to the wikiop. We were living in a little place there.
Get us some whiskey.
Yeah, give me one, too. Ginger ale on the side. The rattlesnake followed me. Followed me down to my shack.
What's the matter with these guys?
Followed me down to the shack. I don't know. Probably drinking too much. Follow me down to the shack. Follow the rattlesnake. Follow me down to the shack. I took my socks off and put it over the snake. My name's Twilly. Cuthbert Dane Twilly. One of the old Back Bay Twilly.
Funny names were a passion with Fields, and throughout his career, he took a great delight in creating the weirdest names for his characters.
D. Ellsworth Stubbins in the flesh. My dear Mrs. Hemoglobin, when I first saw you, I was so enamored with your beauty.
Oh, Mr.
Fields. I ran to the basket, jumped in, went down to the city and bought myself a wedding outfit.
Sport Mulligan tells me you buried your wife several years ago.
Oh, yes, I had to. She died.
Jay Farnsworth Wallaby. He's an Australian sheep man. You played golf with him. Had a friend with him. The Miffin Tip of Boffindale, an Indian potentate.
Og, I'd like you to meet my father. Father, this is Og Ogilvy.
Og Ogilvy. Sounds like a bubble in a bathtub.
Larceny, whipsnake?
Give me that telegram.
It's not larceny. It's larceny. And it's not whipsnake. It's whipsnake.
I used to be one of the Schickelgruber sisters. Remember the Schickelgruber sisters?
No, no,
I love the dumpling.
No, no.
Slackwire.
I told you before never to call me Mr. Bissonette in front of Mrs. Bissonette.
He used ridiculous pseudonyms for himself as writer of his own films, such as Mahatma Kane Jeeves, Otis Cribble Cobblers, and Charles Snavely. He delighted in all kinds of gibberish sounds, as in this introduction to an opera.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor of rendering for your approval this evening the first doojijig of the opera Schreckensnatz by Gilka Kimmel. And Ossip Pipito.
Music itself was something he never cared for, and his rendition of song seems to verify that opinion.
I'd rather have two girls at 21 each than one girl at 42.
What's that tune you're playing?
It's brand new, Commodore. They call it Swanee River.
No good. It'll be forgotten in 2 weeks. People can't remember the tune.
Or this elegant Swiss yodeling song.
And he climbed so high that he reached the sky.
Good night, boy.
Actually, the phrases that he delivered through that magnificent nose was all the music he ever wanted.
What a gorgeous day. What effulgent sunshine. What effulgent sunshine. There was a day of this sort, and McGillicuddy brothers murdered the mother with an axe.